This is Christina with DC Anime Review, and we're going to be discussing Season 1, Episode 16, and joining me is Pooja and Doreen.
We are fucking prophets! We predicted everything in this episode into your eternity!
I know. Oh my god. This is a crazy episode. Like, and I just felt... Okay, like, there's two parts we have to discuss about. Like, the part about... Now I feel bad for that character that we didn't like last episode.
Yeah, Christina, I think you owe Tanori a huge-ass apology, young lady.
Yeah,
definitely I do. I'm really sorry, and I didn't mean it. And I don't know. I thought she was going to be an annoying character, but then this episode just messed with me, and now I feel ashamed of my evil ways. But especially with her father and what happened with her.
That was messed up. But I'm curious to how her mother died.
I know. Yeah. That's the mystery right now because we don't know. All they say is that they think that the father is the one that did it and killed her, but there's no proof on that. And
exactly.
She felt that her father is innocent. That's why she went with her dad on the island.
Yeah. She was a child. You know, she had nothing. If she didn't follow her dad, she would have been, you know, orphan on the streets, and you know, who knows what could have happened to her. She was just a kid.
Exactly.
And I called it the notebook that she has. It wasn't notes that she was writing. She's writing a story.
Yeah, it was a story about her life actually that she was writing about, and it was kind of like the beginning, like. That when the beginning when she was like she loved her father, she loved her mother, and then we don't know if the father really did murder his wife or any, you know, I mean, we don't know.
We don't know the real story behind that.
I'm just wondering if we'll get that answer, that, you know, what happened to Tanori's mother. I'm curious about that.
Yeah. Like, I hope that we will reveal later on, but it's interesting that, like, regardless, she followed her father all the way to that island. That's how she got on the island in the first place. And then knowing that her father went through this torment in order to gain their freedom, like, to free him and her together. And she was, like, praying that every time he was in that torment, she was praying that all those bodies that were killed, you know, because they were trying to fight for their freedom, wasn't her dad down there. And luckily, it wasn't her father that actually was buried there. But the sad part, though, is that when she goes to the boat and she finds the boat.
Yeah, she found the book in the boat. Yeah, because that was a birthday present from her dad because he won the tournament. And then he was going to be the new leader of the island, and then he got poisoned by two jackasses, which I don't even fucking know what their names are. I'm just so annoyed that he had to die that way.
It was messed up, and then for them to even throw him in the water, in the river, like throw him in the water, into the water. And then she walked by, but she, you know, she holds her book really close to her because that's like the only gift she ever that's left of her father that her father gave to her.
And now she uses that book, and you know, we see her backstory is that she, you know, that's how she met her little gang of friends. You know, they were all basically misfits and you know, kids by themselves. They're basically the lost children, like Peter Pan.
Yeah, exactly. That's how I feel. It's like that they are the lost, like the lost boys and girls. They're the lost children. And it's kind of sad because when she keep writing about, like, age 11, age 12 and this, and then she gets to, like, that how people treated her, like, that she took the job only to find in exchange for her freedom.
Yeah, that's all she wanted
to get out of that island.
But people were, like, you know, ridiculing her and, you know, being mean to her. Like, another certain anime series, God damn it, Attack on Titan, stop it with these parallels!
I hope you're not blaming Aaron on something again.
No, I said the series. I said the show.
I know, but I can't, because every time you go into the series, you start to blame Aaron about something.
Not blaming. Well, I mean, there is an owl. There was an owl in that episode. Aaron, is that you?
I don't know. Maybe Aaron came to visit. He's like, okay, I'm just gonna check out everybody over here.
And then we see Tanori. She sees Fushi, and then lo and behold, this bitch comes back. Fuck Hayase. Goddamn it.
Yeah, fuck Hayase. I hate her.
Hayase, I am not happy to see her.
And I'm really pissed. And
she tricked Tanori into telling Fushi and PRN that, oh, there's a boat and the boat's gonna go someplace. That's how she tricked them.
Yeah. I was thinking all this time, oh, this little girl, like, how dare she, like, that's why I'm like, I feel sorry what I said last episode, but this episode, I'm like, oh, okay, this is why.
This is why we shouldn't hate on a character so quickly.
Yeah, I guess I should have learned, though, from watching other animes, but oh well.
Attack on Titan. Gabby.
Yeah.
I have something in my throat, I'm sorry.
Oh. It's okay.
Yeah, sure you did.
She got to drink some water. No, but,
she does.
Yeah, but so the Tanori, like, you feel bad for her character. And the funny thing, I just had a feeling. I said, you know what's going to happen? We're going to find someone that we think she starts annoying. She starts being aggravated. And then you start to change your mind about this character, you know? So it's just crazy how this character, we start to actually feel sorry, especially about her past, and that Hayase, like, manipulate her, trick her, and say, you know, oh, if you get this guy Fushi, he's really good. He's gonna help you win that tournament and everything like that.
No,
like
she tricked Tanori because she could fight him.
Of course, exactly, because she know that. No one's going to defeat him. And she wants a rematch with him. That's what it is. She wants a rematch.
And then we get the biggest bombshell, the way she murdered Panora. My God.
She tortured
her and killed her that way. It was torture.
Yeah. That was torture.
That's really
why, of course, Fushi reacted the way he did. And I don't blame him because... That bitch, the way she went and killed her, went about it, was wrong.
Yeah, that was basically torture.
But she don't give a shit, though. That's the
thing.
Yeah, exactly.
She's very unhinged right now. She's off the walls crazy right now. And then it's like Fushi loses to her because of I think it was like a poison dart. I don't think he's dead. Anyways, he can't die.
Yeah, he can't die. He's immortal.
And then basically she. Hayase basically goes redo of healer on Fushi. Well, hopefully not. We're not crossing that boat. We're not doing that. We're not doing redo of healer in 2 year eternity. No, we're not doing that.
Yeah, no.
No, we're definitely not. We're not going there. But it's just crazy because, and the way how she enjoy kind of describing.
No, she has pleasure in torturing other people. That's it.
That's what a sociopath is.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. But you see how we remember her in the beginning of the series, and now how we see her now became a split personality.
She got her eyes slashed, and her arm chopped off. She has every reason to be crazy.
Yeah, mm-hmm. She went psycho after what happened after Fushi, the way he did it to her, like slashed her in the face. That she got really, she became psychotic.
Yeah.
And then how she's like really disturbingly sick. Like I can see she's sick now.
Yeah,
like she's totally mentally sick.
She's not right in the head that one.
No, and how she was able. Which I'm surprised how she was able to defeat Fushi. But then I understand why she easily defeat Fushi because
he
fought blind
die.
Of rage.
And on top of that, she knows he can't die.
Yeah, so she used a triangle, she used a dart on him, you know, and just
knocked him out.
She just knocked him out. That's what it is. So the crowd think that she killed him, but she didn't. She just knocked him out.
And now she's the new leader of the island, so... We'll see how that goes, and hope I'm praying to whatever god the universe has that those kids come out alive.
But, I know, I hope so too. Oh my
god. But I doubt it.
Yeah, because I see they're going to help him. They're going to save Fushi from the hand of her. And I did not like that preview. Oh, my God.
She freaking licked him, you know?
Now she's gonna make it like her plaything or something? I don't know what she's gonna do to him. I'm like, oh my god. So disturbed.
Let's go into final thoughts.
Yes. Final thoughts. That bitch needs to die. Tanori, I'm sorry for being so evil and mean and, you know, to you. Even though I might still find you annoying, but, you know, I feel bad a little bit for you now.
Yeah.
And that's it. But, yeah, she needs to go and die for what she did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Doreen, final thoughts?
All right. Hayase got to die. She had to die. Because I don't want her end up Nuzi Fushi as a plaything. That's disgusting and gross, disturbing. And I'm going to be tortured with that in my mind of that. And then Tanori, like, we misjudge you, like we did misjudge you, that like we understand why you acted the way you acted, her character, why she behaved that way. And I just hope that Fushi, like with the help of Tanori and all the rest of them, that he actually get also Perrin, you know, the old lady, out of this island already, leave this island, I hope nothing doesn't happen to now Tanori. Now we feel bad, Tanori and her friends. But it's gonna end up bad. I don't know. It's like a bad feeling that Hayase, you know, she's an experienced warrior, so it's not that she's gonna be taken down that easily. Like, she's very skilled. And that's the greatest fear, is like what's gonna happen to them, you know, facing her. You know? Like what kind of, and I just hope that she's going to pay for what she did, especially to Mar's sister and everything. The way she tortured her was uncalled for. It was inhumane, like what she did. It was so wrong. Very wrong what she did.
Yeah,
so
I'm in the same boat as you guys. Fuck Hayase, Tanori. We're sorry for hating on you for that one episode. Fushi, you better get out of there alive with everything intact, I hope.
Yes, I hope so too.
We'll find out next week, and in the meantime, enjoy this podcast. We'll see you guys for another one. Bye.